I talked about my lady a few times so far in the set. I love her very much. We're pretty compatible, but not in every facet of the relationship. We will argue in the car a lot. What will happen is we'll be headed anywhere. And the gaslight will come on. Now, what I do when this happens, and she hates this, by the way, but it's basically my go-to move at this point, pretty much a reflex. I can't not do it. She finds it upsetting every time. What I will do when that happens, brace yourselves. I'm glad you're sitting down, because you probably don't know what's coming. What I will do is put gas in it. That's it. It's a whole move. It's all it takes for me to be fucking wrong, I guess. It's properly responding to the warning the machine's given me, you know. Real dick stuff. Because she interprets that light differently. She sees it as more of a challenge. She's like, don't stop, honey. We can make it. I'm like, you mean as a couple? Because we're getting fucking stranded. We're 40 miles away. We're below empty. Is there a teleporter in the trunk? Boo, I sense a hike coming. You're wearing heels. She's like, relax, babe. It's just a warning. Just a... Yeah, like the one on your blow dryer that says, keep me out of the bathtub. You don't willy-nilly that one, do you? We have warnings for a reason. They keep us not dead. You ever set a nice hot bubble bath for yourself, then plug in a blow dryer, set it on the edge, and spin it for shits and giggles to see how the night works out? We don't tempt fate like that. She's like, calm down, Robert. Have you ever been stranded? I'm like, no, I haven't. Have you? She's like, well, yeah, a few times. Like, well, what the... I think I just won. There goes your shutout. I think shouldn't we go with Johnny Never Stranded on the making it to the destination debate that we have to have right now? Apparently not. Cut to 10 minutes of white knuckle driving later because I have no spine. And she was like, can you exit now? I'm hungry. I was like, well, would you say you're below empty or... Is this your way of warning me that you're starving? Because I've learned to ignore those on this trip, boo. So I exited. I'm not stupid, but I feel like I made my point. It's good to make points. May win that day. I also found out she's not the best at car games. This was a separate road trip we were on. She's like, you want to play a car game? I was like, okay. She's like, what's the saddest memory you have? That's not a game, that's therapy. I didn't agree to car therapy. Saddest memory. I'm driving over a bridge right now, for Christ's sake. Honey, let's try to keep the train of thought in a life is worth living direction. Saddest memory. How is that your car game opener? Don't you want to ease in with something a little lighter? Like, I don't know, I Spy, 20 questions. Cry, bitch. That's what you want me to... Want me to do weaving at 85 miles an hour? All right, fine. Have it your way. Let me turn down this Ario Speedwagon so I can regale you with the time Alzheimer's slowly robbed me of my grandfather. Oh, too dark? Well, I didn't pick the fucking topic. I'd have gone with, I don't know, favorite Ninja Turtle, but you shot first and aimed for trauma, so buckle up for Tear Town. Think we have enough gas to get there. Then it was her turn, and she said some really messed up shit, and we drove home in silence for 6.5 hours. So that's how you play saddest memory. Both get one crack at it, last the whole trip, you both lose. Yeah, cannot recommend it at all. That's a fun way to spend a day. Let's trigger each other through Montana, honey. All right, you got it.